Hey Matterporters, in this video, I really wanted to focus on Showcase and talk about how to best navigate your Matterport model. Maybe you just received a link to a Matterport model from an agent or somebody on your team, and after the model loads, nothing really happens. So you're not quite sure on where to go from here. So let's go ahead and take a look at a Matterport model that I have in Showcase right here. So this model just loaded up for me and I can click and just drag the mouse. And as I look around the room, I can see all these little white circles on the floor. Basically, all that is where the camera was positioned when scanning the area. And so you can navigate yourself to any one of those circles. I can either navigate to one by just taking the cursor and clicking on it, or I can just click up ahead and it'll take me to the nearest one in that direction. So I can turn around, again, using just the mouse to click and drag, and just click up, and it'll take me in the direction of where I click. I can also use the keyboard. Now, I'm personally a big fan of keyboard shortcuts, so I like to navigate using the mouse to turn around, but also the keyboard using the W and the S key on the keyboard to move forward and backwards. So I don't even have to turn around in order to take a step back. I can just press the S key on the keyboard, and it'll move me back. So now that you know basic navigation, let's just take a look real quick at what you have in Showcase. Up in the top left corner, we have the title banner, and I can click the More button here to see more information. This might have contact information or address, things like that. In this case, I don't have it, so I'll just collapse it. And I can also collapse the entire banner right here. Down in the bottom left corner, I can press this little up arrow to show the highlight reel. Now, your model may not have a highlight reel, so you're not going to see that up arrow. But if I do have a highlight reel, I can use the highlights themselves that are in my reel to click on and just navigate directly to those highlights. That's just a quick way of navigating from one highlight to another. I can also press the play button right here in the highlight reel to start playing through the highlight reel and see the model in that way. As this thing is playing through the model, remember, this is not a video, it's a 3D model, so I can stop this at any time just by clicking, and then I can take control and move around. The other buttons here are the dollhouse, so if I click that, it'll show me the dollhouse view and the floor plan view. When I'm in either the dollhouse or the floor plan view, I have access to the inside view, this little person right here, and so I can click there, and it'll take me right back to the scan position where I left. Another icon is the floor selector icon, and this allows me to isolate between floors, and this is very useful for when I'm in the floor plan or dollhouse views. So for example, I'll go into dollhouse, and you can see I'm looking at the entire model, but if I choose the floors and say, let's look at only floor 2, I can isolate that and just look at floor 2 by itself. Now you'll notice that I zoomed in a little bit, and I did that by using the roller wheel on the mouse. So if you have that, it's a really good way of zooming in and out. This works for when you're in the dollhouse view, when you're in the floor plan view, I can zoom in and out, or when I'm in the inside view, I can zoom in and out here too. So let's go back into the kitchen, and I'll just pop into the dollhouse view. I'll find the kitchen and just click anywhere in there, and it'll zip me right to that. And what I want to do in the kitchen is do a little measurement. So this is something that is extremely useful for anybody viewing a model in Showcase. If you have this option enabled for you, that's great. And you'll know that it's enabled because you'll see this little ruler measurements mode icon right here. So when I click that, I'll get into the measurements mode and I can continue to move around anywhere I want. But I can also press this little plus button, which will bring up my measurement mode, and click anywhere I want. I can just click once and then drag, or I can double click and it'll just draw a line that is perfectly perpendicular to the surface on which I clicked. So now you'll notice that another line is being dragged out, but I'm done. I just want to leave it at that. And so I'll press the check mark here and that's it. So I know that between this cabinet and the stove is going to be 5 feet. And I can also go back out to the dollhouse and see that it's perfectly perpendicular. And that is 5 feet between these two. And that's going to be extremely useful information for me because I like to have a good amount of space between the stove and the sink so that I know that somebody can be working at the stove and somebody else working at the sink at the same time, comfortably without running into each other. So this was really helpful to know the distance between those two for me. Hopefully that was helpful. And now that you feel a lot more comfortable navigating a Matterport model in Showcase, I went ahead and linked to a model in the description below so you can go ahead and play around.